brethren. I pray you sing to the Lord a new song. Sing praise in the assembly of the righteous. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud on their beds. Let the high praise of God be on the mouths of the saints and a two-edged sword in their hands to execute vengeance on the demonic nations and punishments on those peoples, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute on them this written judgment. This honor hath all his saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Sing to him a new song. Praise the Lord. Brethren, I pray you sing to the Lord a new song. Sing praise in the assembly of the righteous. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud on their beds. Let the high praise of God be on the mouths of the saints and a two-edged sword in their hand to execute vengeance on the demonic nations and punishments on those peoples, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute on them this written judgment. This honor hath all his saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Sing to him a new song.
Revelation chapter 14 verse 3, and they sung as it were a new song before the throne and before the four beasts and the elders, and no man could learn that song but the 144,000 which were redeemed from the earth. We're seeing prophecy play out in real time on the planet. You brothers out there that's teaching this word in sincerity and in truth, you will be that 144,000. That would be you. And you're singing that song right now. And you're the only ones that know it. Okay? The Lord gave this truth to his elect. This is why it says how the majority of our people can't find what they're seeking for, but the election have obtained it, and the rest were blinded, because no man could learn that song but the 144,000. And that song is this truth. That song is judgment. That song is Yahweh Shai coming back and destroying the wicked and putting them in slavery. That's the song. And it's all around the planet Earth, mainly in Babylon the Great, but it's all around the planet right now, because you have Israelite camps from Great Millstone in every country on the earth right now, singing the same song. Isaiah chapter 40 and verse 10. Behold, the Lord Yahweh will come with strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. Right, so our power is coming back with a strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. His arm is Yahweh Shai, and his reward is with him. He's going to reward brothers for teaching his word. Okay? Isaiah chapter 42 and verse 10. Sing unto Yahweh a new song, and his praise from the end of the earth. Are not we in the end of the earth? We've been removed from the east to the west. We're in the western hemisphere now. the majority of us. Let me read that again. Isaiah 42 and 10. Sing unto Yahweh a new song, this truth, and his praise from the end of the earth. And that's how you know it's not an actual song. It's his praise. We're praising Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. From the end of the earth. Is that not happening right now? Ye that go down to the sea and all that is therein, the isles and the inhabitants thereof. Do not we have brothers on the islands? You have brothers in Jamaica, brothers in the Bahamas. Okay? Brothers in Trinidad. Is that not happening right now? You got a brother in Costa Rica. So you see it, man. This is happening. Get this in your mind that this is happening right now. So we know of a surety that Yahweh Shai is coming back. We know that for a fact. Isaiah, the book of Isaiah, again, because Isaiah got some heat in it. Isaiah chapter 42 and verse 21. Yahweh is well pleased for his righteousness' sake. He will magnify the law and make it honorable, because that's a part of the song. He's coming back to judge people according to the law. Okay, and he's pleased for his elect's sake. You brothers out there. The book of Psalms, chapter 40 and verse 3. And he hath put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our power. Many shall see it and fear, and shall trust in Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. That's why we're doing this work. Through the terror of the Lord, we persuade men. So a lot of you Israelites, you're hearing this song, and you're fearing. And you're coming into the truth. You come into this truth through fear. Okay? Yeah, you love the Lord, but really, the Lord wants you to fear him. Fear is greater than love. And our power is definitely coming back for judgment, man. A lot of people are about to get put to death. That's a part of the song. Psalms chapter 96, verse 1. Oh, sing unto Yahweh a new song. Sing unto Yahweh all the earth. Right, because this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations. Sing unto Yahweh, bless his name, Yahweh. Show forth his salvation from day to day. Are not we doing that when we prophesy? Declare his glory among the heathen, his wonders among all people. Wait a minute. Now, how are we going to do that? And why are we doing that? Remember how it said we would sing unto him from the end of the earth? Right? Now, this is the book of Tobit, chapter 13, verse 3. Confess him before the Gentiles, ye children of Israel, for he hath scattered us among them. There declare his greatness and extol him before all the living. For he is our Lord, and he is the Most High, our Father forever. And he will scourge us for our iniquities and will have mercy again, and will gather us out of all nations among whom he hath scattered us. That's the song we're singing, that the Lord is going to gather us from all nations where he scattered us. Yep. He that scattered Israel will gather him. That's what's about to happen. And keep him as a shepherd does his flock. Did not Yahweh Shai say he is not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel? You brothers, man, this is you. Psalms chapter 96 and verse 3. There declare his glory. Let me read this again. Psalms 96 and 3. Declare his glory among the heathen, his wonders among all people. For Yahweh is great and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the nations are idols, but Yahweh made the heavens. And that's what we're saying. We have the true omnipotent power. We have the only power. Okay, all these other gods are not real. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Give unto Yahweh, O ye kindreds of the people. Give unto Yahweh glory and strength. Give unto Yahweh the glory due unto his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. And you brothers, you are that offering now. We are the offering. Okay, we are the sacrifice. We're presenting our bodies as a living sacrifice. Give unto Yahweh the glory, do unto his name, bring an offering, and come into his courts. Oh, worship Yahweh in the beauty of holiness. Fear before him all the earth. And that's what we're saying. Fear before him. Say among the heathen that Yahweh reigneth. Right? Because we're declaring his glory among the Gentiles, because he scattered us among them. The world also shall be established that it shall not be moved. And that's what we're telling the people. The whole planet Earth is not going to be destroyed. Just America. For all its wickedness. But the earth is going to be here, because the kingdom of heaven is going to be on the earth. He shall judge the people righteously. Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Right? Because our power is bringing judgment. He's about to put everything back in order. That's what he's about to do. Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Right? Because the ozone layer is polluted. You know? Got all types of filth up in the heavens. You got plastic and all types of filth in the water. So the planet Earth is rejoicing that the Lord is about to come back. Let the sea roar in the fullness thereof. The whole planet Earth. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein. Then shall all the trees of the wood rejoice. The planet Earth. Why? Why is it rejoicing? Before Yahweh. For he cometh to judge the earth. Right? So Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is coming back to judge the earth. That's the new song. That's the song. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is coming back to judge the earth. Yahweh Shai is about to make his second coming. That's the new song. Let me read that again. Psalms chapter 96, verse 12. Let the field be joyful in all that is therein. Then shall all the trees of the wood rejoice. Hey, is not Esau cutting down rainforests, chopping down all these trees? He's destroying the earth. So the trees of the wood are rejoicing before Yahweh, Bashem Yahweh Shai, for he cometh to judge the earth. That new song is about judgment, the prophecies, righteousness being established. He shall judge the world with righteousness and the people with his truth. This new song is his truth. Because people look at us like, well, nah, that's your truth. That's y'all interpretation. That's what you saying. No, we're simply reading it for what it say. We're reading it how it says it. We're reading it in its proper context. Okay? There is no private interpretation. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is coming back to bring judgment. All right? That's the new song. His truth. This word. The prophecies. And through the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, only the elect understand it. Only the elect are going to be able to grasp it. So, with that, I hope you brothers were edified. Let me read one more scripture. Psalms chapter 98, verse 1. Oh, sing unto Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai a new song, for he have done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have gotten him the victory. Psalms 98 and 1. Oh, sing unto Yahweh a new song, for he have done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have gotten him the victory. Yahweh Shai is coming back. He is coming back.